Hey, what's up, guys? Today I'm going to be showing you how to pass variables to different classes. So say you have a variable name, and you want to pass that variable to your other class so the other class can use it. This definitely comes in handy when making big Java programs, which we haven't been doing. We've been making little ones, but it definitely comes in handy. So I actually have taught you how to call other classes, but I've only taught you how to call static classes. And I don't like static. I probably should have told you how to call regular classes because you barely use static, only on rare occasions. So I'm going to teach you how to call regular classes too. So let's create let's create a method. And let's name this method printName. So let's write public void print name, and then we will do that and make it. Okay. So once we have print name, we have to add an argument. So if you look here, between these two parentheses is where we add arguments and is where we will be passing variables. You actually already see arguments already in Java. For example, if you look at main, main accepts arguments like string and args. So those are two different arguments. So let's add an argument or a variable. So our variable is going to be a string, and it's going to be called received name. So let's type string received name. So what this has done is it's just created a simple string inside our print name method. It's actually really the same exact thing as typing string received name in here. But obviously it's returning errors because string received name has already been declared. But the thing that's good about this is that it can be called and messed with from other classes. So let's go to our another class we have. I've created a class called other class right here. I don't think you can see it because there's not much room. But make sure you have your main class, and then you've created another class called Other Class. So inside Other Class, we're going to have a method called EnterName. I've already created it, but I'll create it again just so you can see. So what you do is you type public void EnterName. Okay, and that's all we need. We will be messing with this class later. So let's go back to our main, which is here, and let's work with this. So actually I'm gonna close all others so I can organize this better. There we go, and we'll open another class and da da da. Okay, so now it's much more organized. So inside print name, we are going to print something to the console. Actually no, first let's call this method. So I had taught you how to call static methods from other classes. Since it's not a static method, we have to call it a different way. And the way we do that is we make an object. So you know what objects are. I'll make the object so I can explain it a little bit better. So type other class, because that's the name of our class file. Let's set a variable, so call class. Let's set it equal to new other class with no arguments. So what is this object, or what is an object in general? I've been pretty broad with what objects are, and I'll explain it right now. An object is actually just, well, a class. The class, you call the class, and you call specific methods within that class, and you can mess with those methods and get the information you want. You remember the scanner object, right? Scanner is actually a class, just like other class is a class. So really what objects are just links to the different classes. Now let's call this call class method. Now I know I've been saying class a lot, but just bear with me here. So the way we call the call class method is we type call class dot, and you'll see that it's trying to autocomplete it for us. We're going to do enter name because that's the name of our method. So once we've called it, that means all the code inside here will be executed. So let's type some stuff for it to execute. Let's create a string. Let's call this string name. Let's also make a scanner object, so scanner sc equals new scanner system object.in. Okay, and now the reason it's complaining is because we didn't import scanner. So let's type import java.util.scanner. Okay, and now let's call the sendName method, which is located in here. So the way we do that is we type main, because we're calling the main class, sendName equals new main. So once we've done that, we can print something to the console. Let's make it a little bit less confusing. Let's write system.out.println, enter your name. And then below, let's set name, our variable, equal to sc.nextLine. I know this looks familiar. And then what we're going to do is we're going to call our sendName method. So, where is sendName? I'm not sure. All right, well, what calling sendName means is we are going to call this printName method, and we are going to set our variable name equal to this string, which is called receivedName. So it's actually pretty easy. All we have to do is do sendName, which is our variable, and then dot printName. Now, you'll see that it's trying to autocomplete it for us, and I'll explain why. PrintName, which is our method right here, receives a variable, which is our string called receivedName. We need to tell printName what variable to take in. We can't tell it to receive nothing, or else it gets confused, saying, hey, I have a variable in here, and I need you to take something to fill it up with. So let's do that. Let's fill that variable with the string name. So what this will do is it will call sendName, our method. It'll call printName, our method, and it'll say, okay, you're trying to set name equal to this variable called receivedName. So now that we've done that, we can actually print out the name in that other class. So all we have to do is type system.out.println, you entered, and then plus received name. So what this will do is it'll print the name we entered in this class. Now you might see this little light bulb, and it's saying that scanner was never closed, so let's close it just for good housekeeping. Let's do sc.close, and that's all we have to do. So let's go ahead and run this, save, and take a look at the console. It says enter your name. I'm going to enter BL walk 2222. And it says you entered BL walk 2222. And to end this, I will tell you what happened. Inside our main class, which is the class we normally work in, we created a variable called call class. Well, we created an object called call class. So what this object does is it calls our method called enterName, which is located in this class. So once enterName, this method, is called, it will execute this code. What this code does is it declares a variable, it uses the scanner, and then we created an object. This object is called sendName. What this object does is it allows us to send variables over to our other method called printName. So we also printed out enter your name, and then we took in a variable from the scanner, and then we sent over that variable we took in from the scanner to this method, and we set that variable to our string called received name, and then we printed out our received name. So I know that sounds like a lot of steps, but it's actually much simpler once you get used to it. Just remember that it's just pretty much passing variables back and forth, as many times as you'd like, so it doesn't get all cluttered up and really hard to read. But that's it for this tutorial, and I will see you in the next one.